The following is a Rathyatra lecture given by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on July 12, 1975 in Philadelphia.
Ladies and gentlemen, first of all, I wish to thank you, the inhabitants of this great city, Philadelphia. You are so kind, enthusiastic in taking part in this movement, so I am very much obliged to you. I am especially obliged to the American boys and girls who are helping me so much in spreading this Krishna consciousness movement in the Western countries. I was ordered by my spiritual master to preach this Krishna consciousness in the Western countries. So in 1965, I first came in New York. Then in 1966, this society was regularly registered in New York, and from 1967 this movement is regularly going on in America, Europe, Canada, and south of Pacific Ocean, Australia, and throughout the whole world. So, I may inform you little about this movement, Krishna consciousness. Krishna, this word, means all attractive. Krishna is attractive to every living entity. Not only human being, even the animals, birds, bees, trees, flowers, fruits, water, that is the picture of Vrindavan. This is material world. We have no experience of the spiritual world, but we can get a glimpse idea what is spirit and what is matter. Just try to understand the difference between a living man and a dead body. The dead body means as soon as the living force within the body is gone, then it is dead matter, useless. And so long the living force is there, the body is very important. So as we experience in this body, there is something as dead matter and something as living force. Similarly, there are two worlds, the material world and the spiritual world. We living entities, every one of us, we belong to the spiritual world. We do not belong to the material world. Somehow or other, we are now in contact with this material world and material body, and the business is that although we are eternal living force, on account of our contact with this material body, we have to take four tribulations, birth, death, disease and old age, that we have to undergo. In this material world, we are getting one type of body and it is ended at a certain stage, just like any material thing. Take example of your dress. You are dressed with a certain type of garment, but when it is worn out, no more usable, then you throw it, you get another dress. So this material body is the dress of the spirit living force. But because we are attached to this material world, we want to enjoy this material world, we get different types of body. It is explained in the Bhagavad Gita as machine. Actually it is machine, this body. In the Bhagavad Gita it is said, Ishara sarvabhutanam riddeshe arjuna tishtati brahmayan sarvabhutani jantra rurani mayaya. So, we living entity, we desire. Man proposes, God disposes. God is very kind. Whatever you desire, He will fulfill. Although He says that this kind of material desires will never satisfy you. But we want. Therefore, God supplies us, Krishna, different types of body to fulfill our different desires. This is called material conditional life. This body, change of body according to desire, is called evolutionary process. By evolution, we come to the human form of body through many other millions bodies. Jalajana malakhani sthavara lakkavinsati. We pass through 900,000 species of form in the water. Similarly, 2 million forms as plants, trees. In this way, by nature's way, nature brings us into this human form of life just to develop or awaken our consciousness. Nature gives us the chance. Now what you want to do? Now you have got developed consciousness. Now you again want to go to the evolutionary process, or you want to go to the higher planetary system, or you want to go to God, Krishna, or you want to remain here. These options are there. It is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, Janti deva vrata devan pitrin janti pitrin vrataha bhute ja janti bhutani madhya jino pi janti maam. Now make your selection. If you want to go to the higher planetary system, you can go. If you want to remain here in the middle planetary system, you can do so. And if you want to go to the lower planetary system, that you can do. And if you want to go to God, Krishna, that also you can do. It is up to your option. Therefore, what is the difference between this material world, maybe in the higher planetary system or in the lower planetary system, and what is the spiritual world? The spiritual world means there is no material consumption. Everything is spirit, as I told you. The trees, the flowers, the fruits, the water, the animals, everything is spiritual. So there is no annihilation. It is eternal. So if you want to go to that spiritual world, then you can have this opportunity now in this human form of life. And if you want to remain in this material world, you can do so. So our movement is that Why not stop this material conditional life, repetition of birth, death, old age and disease? This is intelligence. Why should we remain in this material body and undergo repetition, change of body? Let us have our original spiritual body. That is one, that is intelligence. The human life is therefore meant, as it is stated in the Vedanta philosophy, athāta brahma jigyāsa. Now, this life is meant for inquiring about the Absolute Truth. So, that is required, that is human intelligence. And if we spoil our life like the animals, they are also eating, we are also eating, they are also sleeping, we are also sleeping, they are also having sex intercourse, we are also having sex intercourse, they are also depending, we are also depending. These four principles are common to the human being and to the animal. The special advantage of human being is that if he likes, he can stop this repetition of birth and death and go back to home, back to God. The Krishna consciousness movement is trying to educate people about this science, how to go back to home, back to God. It is not a so-called religious movement. Of course, anything which has connection with God, you can take it as religious movement, but it is very scientific movement. For the big scientists, philosophers, thinkers, they should try to understand this movement. We have got 57 books for convincing the philosopher scientist. If you want to know the value of this movement through science, philosophy, we have got enough ingredients to supply you. Otherwise, it is simple, very simple. Simply chant this mantra, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Then everything will be manifest to you. Cheta darpana marjanam. This chanting of Hare Krishna mantra means cleansing the core of your heart. Because our heart, our mind, our consciousness is now covered with so many dirty things. If we chant this Hare Krishna mantra, then these dirty things will be cleansed. Then we shall be able to see what I am, what is my position, what is my goal of life, what I have to do. This is human consideration. The dogs, cats, they cannot do that. But a human being, they can do it very nicely. So, on account of this, you will find that this young man, not only from your country, but in other countries also, in Africa, in Australia, in Canada, in Europe, in Asia, everywhere, as soon as they are understanding this philosophy, they are joining this movement, and it is not very difficult. We don't charge anything about selling Hare Krishna mantra. We are chanting everywhere. That you saw this Ratha Yatra. Our only means is chanting Hare Krishna. And these thousands of men are following simply by chanting Hare Krishna mantra. So you can understand what is the potency of this Hare Krishna mantra. We do not pay anything, you ladies and gentlemen, to follow us, but we simply chant Hare Krishna. So, it is very potential Narottama Das Thakur, a great acharya of Vaishnava Sampradaya, he has sung Golokera Premadhana Hari Nama Sankirtana. This Hare Krishna movement or chanting of Hare Krishna, it is not anything material. Therefore, you will never feel tired chanting Hare Krishna. You see practically. You go on chanting 24 hours, you will never feel tired. Therefore, it is said, Golokera Premadhana. This chanting vibration is coming from the spiritual world. Just like you receive material sound vibration in the radios or television from distant place, there is another machine which can receive the vibration in the spiritual world. So that vibration is Hare Krishna mantra. Golokera Premadhana Hari Nama Sankirtana Ratina Janmila Kanata. Oh, I am so unfortunate that I did not get any attachment for chanting this Hare Krishna mantra. Saṃsāra dāvānāle divānisi hiya jale. This saṃsāra, this material world, is very uncomfortable place. Everyone is always full of anxiety. However rich you may be, however powerful you may be, but the anxiety must be there. You can understand your President Nixon, how much anxiety he had when all people wanted him to come down. So, this material world means, in whichever position you may be situated, it doesn't matter. It is full of anxiety. This is called blazing fire, always burning the heart. So if you want to get relief from this uncomfortable position of anxiety, then you must take to this Hare Krishna mantra. This is our request. You can try for it and you will see the practical result. It will not cost you anything. There is no loss about it. So our only request is with folded hands and begging you so many flatterings, we simply request Danti Nidhayatnakam Padayu Nipatta. This is our process. We are not very violent pushing. Now you see our procession came from me for 3 hours. There was no violence. The police department of your country, they very much appreciate, because they have got experience. Whenever there is some procession, there is violence. Wind-breaking crowd, they say. But these people are not wind-breaking crowds. So, this Krishna consciousness movement, you have already accepted it, this movement, your so many young men. So, we request, this is another occasion to invite you. So our only request is that you chant Hare Krishna mantra and you will feel very much happy. There will be no anxiety. And then you can do your work. It doesn't matter what you are doing. But chanting of this Hare Krishna mantra will make you more and more happy, free from material anxieties. And if we continue this process, then everything will be clearly understood about spiritual life, and very easily we shall be able to go back to home, back to garden. Now this occasion, I may explain a little bit. Here you see Jagannath and Balaram and Subhadra. There, Krishna and his elder brother and his sister, Subhadra. There is a place in India about 90 miles north of Delhi You have heard the name of New Delhi. The place is named Kurukshetra. It is accepted as the holy place, pilgrimage. People is still gathered there, especially during the eclipse, solar and lunar eclipse. So there was once, 5,000 years ago, there was a solar eclipse, and all people from all parts of India, they came to Kurukshetra, and Krishna at that time was prince at Dwarka. He also came with his elder brother and sister. Krishna, in his childhood, he was raised as the foster son of Maharaj Nanda and Mother Yashoda in Vrindavan. Then when he was grown up, we'll find this history in the Krishna book. So the incident is that Krishna was the beloved personality in Vrindavan. So when he left Vrindavan, all the people there, they are very, very unhappy. So when Krishna came to Kurukshetra from Dwarka with his brother and sister, these people in Vrindavan, they got news that Krishna is coming there. Vrindavan is about the same distance. Kurukshetra is greater distance. Anyway, they came to see Krishna out of their love. And the most beloved personality, Srimati Radharani, she was requesting Krishna that you are the same Krishna, I am the same Radharani, but the place is not the same. You are here in Kurukshetra, in royal opulence, and you are coming from the village. So, if you again please come to Vrindavan. This was Radharani's request, and it is very ecstatic feeling. Those who are advanced devotee, they can enjoy. So, we observe this incident annually in as many places in the Western countries. At the present moment, we hold this ceremony in London, San Francisco, Chicago, Philadelphia, and where is Buffalo, Melbourne, yes. So, this is a very feeling festival, so I thank you very much. You have come here and try to understand our philosophy. You are all educated boys and girls. We have got 57 books. Try to read and try to understand and take it very seriously, and you will be happy. Thank you very much.